Hi everyone, and once again a very good evening to all of you. Welcome back once again to the channel. So there are certain mistakes that we all do while preparing for anything, right? While doing anything, not preparing, not just preparing for an examination. If we are doing any job, if you are doing any work, we being human beings have certain tendency to commit some mistakes. But अगर हमें पहले से पता हो कि ये मिस्टेक हो सकती है, if we know in advance that this mistake could happen, then we can already prepare for that and work on that, right? So here in this video, guys, I'm going to tell you about those five mistakes that you might be doing during your preparations of RBI Grade B examination, and these mistakes, mark my words, can cost you the entire RBI Grade B examination, right? I'm not threatening you about this, but yes, I'm telling you the truth. This is the fact. Agar aap ye galtiyan kar rahe hain, then you will not be able to clear this examination or any other examination of the country. ठीक है, तो चलो बात करते हैं. नंबर वन, पहली मिस्टेक दैट यू मस्ट बी डूइंग इज यू आर नॉट डूइंग एक्टिव रिविजन. सी, यू मस्ट बी डूइंग रिविजन. ऑल ऑफ यू विल से, नहीं भाई हम तो रिविजन कर रहे हैं, वी आर डूइंग द रिविजन. यू मस्ट बी डूइंग रिविजन, बट रीड द वर्ड प्रॉपरली, एक्टिव रिविजन. यू नीड टू डू एक्टिव रिविजन. नाउ what डू आई मीन बाय एक्टिव रिविजन हियर? एक्टिव रिविजन का क्या मतलब है? देखो भाई, एक्टिव रिविजन का मतलब है कंटिन्यूअस रिविजन. वॉट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ एक्टिव रिविजन? इट्स कॉन्टिन्यूअस रिविजन. नाउ वॉट डू आई मीन बाय कॉन्टिन्यूअस रिविजन? सो मोस्ट ऑफ यू, वॉट यू गाइज आर डूइंग राइट नाउ इज यू गाइज आर स्टडिंग फॉर वन मंथ एंटायर और टू मंथ एंटायर एंड गिविंग द एंटायर थर्ड मंथ फॉर द रिविजन. दिस इज द इनकरेक्ट वे ऑफ रिविजन. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली इनकरेक्ट वे ऑफ रिविजन. डू नॉट फॉलो दिस मेथड, बिकॉज लेट मी टेल यू what's going to happen here. Whatever you read on the very first day of this first month, you will not be able to recall when you will start revision. So this third month when you are starting the revision is absolutely new for whatever you have read in these 2 months. So that's why you need continuous revision or active revisions. How you can do it? So every weekend, devote for whatever you have read in the previous week. From Monday to Saturday, whatever you have read, whatever you have studied, you have to revise it on Sunday, right? This is how you need to have active revision, because the syllabus is so vast, especially if I talk about the government schemes and current affairs parts. There are so many facts, there are so much information, right? So it is impossible without active revision that you guys able to recall everything. Most of the time I get this question that I am unable to recall everything, how to do current affairs. There is only one way is, and that is the active revision. You need to do the active revision. And how to do the active revision? There is a very beautiful video made by Anuj sir. You can search for active revision by Anuj Jindal. You can find that video, right? So number one is this. What is the second mistake that can cost you your entire examination? Is that you are not attempting weekly test. You are not attempting the weekly test. कि मैं काम कर रहा हूं और मुझे पता ही नहीं है कि मैं काम सही कर रहा हूं या गलत कर रहा हूं. So do you think that such work should be done? I am doing a work, right? I am doing a certain amount of work, right? Now I don't know whether I am doing it correctly or incorrectly. Then what is the point of doing the work? When you are doing your job, aap aise kai log working professionals honge, theek hai? So whatever work you must be doing, usko check karne ke liye aapke upar koi na koi authority definitely hogi. Ya aapko pata bhi to hona chahiye ki aap kaam sahi kar rahe ho ya nahi kar rahe ho. Same goes with the preparations, no? Same goes with the studies, isn't it? If you are preparing for anything, if you are studying anything, you should test yourself that whether you have understood the concept or not, you have understood the subject or not, and you have understood any particular chapter or not. And how you can do it? By attempting the weekly test, my dear friends. Let's say today you have studied any particular chapter of quant, let's say profit and loss, right? You have studied, you have practiced certain questions. Now how do you know that you have studied it as per the pattern of examination, as per the examination standard? How do you know? आप तो अपने टॉपसी टर्वी लैंड में जी रहे हो कि हाँ भाई, मैंने तो कर लिया प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस, क्वांट का सिलेबस खत्म हो चुका है. बट खत्म होने से क्या हो रहा है? Have you ever tested yourself that whether you have done it properly as per the exam pattern, as per the requirements of the examination or not? And this can be only done through the weekly test. You need to test yourself again and again, only then you will be able to identify what all mistakes you are doing. एग्जाम में मिस्टेक करने से अच्छा, माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, एग्जाम से पहले कर लो, क्योंकि एग्जाम में अगर मिस्टेक होगी तो बड़ा दुख होगा, राइट? So that was number two. What is number three? Number three, you are still juggling among the resources. You are still juggling among the resources. What do I mean by this? See, what is most of the student, ye maine dekha hai, I have seen this tendency among the most of the students that they are searching everything for free on YouTube. Theek hai, it's your right. You can search everything on YouTube, but you don't have to juggle among these sources. You need to identify, you need to understand that what source, what resource is right for you. I can understand because YouTube pe bhi information ki baad aa chuki, right? There is a, you know, storm of information on YouTube, on Telegram, everywhere you can get the PDFs related to your examination, for whatever examination you are preparing, right? So in this you know, storm of information, first of all you need to identify what is right for you, right? A particular and you know, certain classes given by a particular channel might be beneficial for a particular set of student, and it might not be beneficial for another set of student. So you need to identify that what is right for you and stop juggling among the resources. Ek ye tendency hoti hai ki hum sab kuch karke chale jayenge. Nobody can do everything and nobody in this world knows everything. Mark my words. Aisa ho hi nahi sakta. Ab jaise for example, if I talk about government scheme, to government, kya tum sari government scheme karke ja sakte ho? It is absolutely not possible. And if you are thinking so ki chalo 100 government scheme Manish sir ne kara di hai, main yahan se kar leta hu, 500 scheme usne kara di hai, 500 uski kar leta hu, 200 usne kara di hai, uski kar leta hu. It is not possible. You won't be able to do that. So you need to identify what is right for you, and then you have to trust on that resource. Then you have to trust on source that, okay, I will be doing this much only from this particular channel or from this particular resource. Theek hai, trust karo. And I think guys, you are mature enough. Aap sab log graduate to hoi at least. Theek hai, to it's you know, ye aapko pata hai ki aapke liye kya sahi hai aur kya nahi sahi hai. All right. So that was number three. Now what is number four? No writing practice. See, when the phase one examination is conducted, after the phase one examination I got so many calls that I haven't practiced answer writing yet, what should I do? You won't be able to do anything at that point of time. Mark my words. Theek hai, I agree that this is not the right time to start answer writing practice, but after a few months, you know, I would say in the from the month of February or March, you should start doing the answer writing practice, because before this you should be focusing on completing the syllabus. And once you are done with the syllabus, you should you know, very comprehensively practice the answer writing. We will be starting very soon in our course the answer writing practice of finance and management, because the syllabus of finance and management will soon be done. So after that we will be doing the answer writing practice, right? So basically, first of all, you need to cover the syllabus and then you have to practice the answer writing. Now most of the student ki ek complaint aur hai ki bhai jo UPSC ka student hai na, usko edge milta hai yahan pe. Are my dear friend, agar usko edge mil raha hai to, agar aapke paas wo edge nahi hai to aap us edge ko achieve kar sakte ho na. If you do not have that edge of answer writing, then you can achieve that edge how? By practicing the answer writing. What is the difference between you and a UPSC candidate? What is the difference? The difference is only one, that the UPSC candidate has practiced the answer writing and you have not. That is the only difference. So today you start answer writing practice, you will be at par with that UPSC student. Then why are you complaining that UPSC student have an edge in this area? I think you should not be complaining. So answer writing practice guys is very very important, because agar answer writing ki agar hum baat kare, so what is the weightage of answer writing? What is the, you know, significance of answer writing? If I talk about phase 2 ki baat karo, English descriptive 100 number ka pura, right? ESI 50 marks, FM 50 marks, and this is English, and 50 marks objective, 50 marks descriptive. So out of 300 200 marks, yani 2/3 of the weightage of the exam depends on your answer writing practice. So do not take this lightly. You can see here, if you are not practicing the answer writing, if you have not practiced it, you won't be able to clear the examination, because 2/3 of the paper, 2/3 of the examination consists of, depends on your answer writing. All right. So I hope it is clear. And now last but not the least, current versus syllabus. Again, the students are confused that when we should start doing the current affairs, how can we manage doing syllabus and current affairs, what is the right time to start current affairs. There is no right time. This is the right time. Today is the right time. Right now is the right time to start current affairs, right? And how you can manage current affairs and your syllabus? Kaise kar sakte ho manage? Main batata hu, there is a very simple way. Divide your day into three parts. Divide your this mistake, guys. Every one of you is doing this mistake. Ki you are right now you are focusing just on syllabus, and after 1 month you will be focusing only on the current affairs. This is not the way to prepare for the any examination, whether it is UPSC, RBI, NABARD, any examination you are preparing for. Current affairs or syllabus ko saath saath leke chalna hota hai. You can't do ki bhai ek mahine mein aapne syllabus kar liya FM ka, right? Uske baad agle second mahine mein aapne current affairs kar liya, fir third mahine mein fir again aap syllabus pe aa gaye, static syllabus pe. This is not the way. Galat tarika hai ye bhai, mat karo aise. If you are following this way, please do not do this, right? What you have to do is you have to divide your day into two or three parts. Let me explain you that. Part 1, part 2, part 3. In this part 1, what you can do is cover the syllabus. Cover the syllabus. In this part 2, that is in the afternoon, you can do the current affairs and again syllabus. Now the working professional will say that how we'll be doing current affairs during our office hours. Office mein लंच के समय अपने कुलीग के साथ गप्पे मारना बंद करो. यू शुड स्टॉप डूइंग गॉसिप्स विद योर कुलीग ड्यूरिंग द लंच टाइम, ड्यूरिंग योर फ्री टाइम, ड्यूरिंग योर सुट्टा ब्रेक्स, राइट? स्टॉप डूइंग दैट. इन योर सुट्टा ब्रेक यू कैन डू करंट अफेयर्स. इन योर लंच ब्रेक क्विकली फिनिश द लंच एंड डू द करंट अफेयर्स. इफ यू आर इन द बैंक जस्ट पुट द मोबाइल फोन एंड पुट योर ईयरफोन. अगर काम नहीं है तो यू कैन डू द करंट अफेयर्स, राइट? सो दिस इज हाउ यू हैव टू मैनेज. प्लीज डू नॉट बी अ क्राई बेबी एंड से कि भाई मेरे पास तो टाइम ही नहीं है. ठीक है, तो देखो एक हिंदी में एक कहावत है कि अगर ओखल में सर दिया है तो मूसल से क्या डरना, राइट? सो इफ यू हैव जम्प्ड इन अ वेल तो फिर नाउ यू डोंट हैव टू मेजर इट्स डेप्थ एंड फियर ऑफ इट्स एंड गेट यू नो थ्रेटन्ड अबाउट इट्स डेप्थ. ऐसा मत करो अपने साथ. अगर आपने देना है तो आपको करना है, दैट्स इट. एंड पीपल आर डूइंग इट. यू कैन सी अ लॉट ऑफ वर्किंग प्रोफेशनल्स आर क्लियरिंग दिस एग्जामिनेशन, राइट? So this is how you can divide your day. Or you can do one thing: morning hour syllabus, evening hour current affairs. Let's say that you have a very hectic job, then you can eliminate this part: morning hour syllabus or evening hour current affairs. Or you can do vice versa as well: morning hours current affairs or evening hours you can devote to the static syllabus, right? So guys, these were the 5 mistakes that I know most of the candidates are doing and will also do in future. तो मैं फिर से बार बार आपको अपनी वीडियोज में इन 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 चीजों के बारे में याद दिलाता रहूंगा ताकि आप लोग ये मिस्टेक बार बार कमिट ना करें. ठीक है, सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर दिस वीडियो. एंड दिस कोर्स इज नाउ लाइव. फाइनेंस एंड मैनेजमेंट लाइव क्लासेज आर गोइंग ऑन. फ्रॉम जनवरी आई विल बी स्टार्टिंग द इकोनॉमिक एंड सोशल इश्यूज लाइव क्लासेस. एंड ट्रस्ट मी मजा आ जाएगा. बिकॉज आई हैव बीन वर्किंग फॉर लास्ट 1 week and for next 1 month I will be working on this ESI. How I can make ESI more interesting for the students. Trust me, maza aaya. Iske aage main kuch nahi bolunga. Theek hai. And if you want to inquire about this course, you can call on 9999466225. The team will guide you everything. Fir milte hain kisi aur video mein kisi aur naye sawal ke saath. Till then keep studying and keep studying hard. Goodbye, take care and God bless.